Hello friends, this video on Introduction to Trigonometry Part 7 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Before watching this video, please make sure that you have watched Part 1 to Part 6. We'll now study trigonometric ratio of some specific angles. We'll find trigonometric ratio of 45 degree, 30 degree and 60 degree, and we'll also find 0 degree and 90 degree. All these angles are very much required in solving the questions, so we'll go for these three. Let's go for 45 degree. So if this angle is 45 degree, let's suppose this angle is 90 degree, this angle will also be 45. Why? Because sum of angle is 180. 45, this is 90, we already know. So this angle has to be 45. Because sum of these two angles will be 90. Correct? If the angles are equal, the sides AB and BC will be equal. Let's assume the length of AB is X, so BC will also be X. Correct? See, we have done that. We have seen that to find trigonometric ratios, all the trigonometric ratios, the first thing we have to do is we have to find the sides of the triangle. So if we can find the sides of this triangle, we can find the trigonometric ratio. So here we can see that this is right triangle. So we can say that AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Correct? And this is nothing but x square plus x square, or AC is equal to root of 2x square, that is nothing but root 2x. So AC is nothing but root 2x. So let me assume sine A, because sine 45 is sine A actually, right? So let me assume A as my angle. So A is my frame of reference. This is H. Side adjacent will be base. This is B. And side opposite is perpendicular, so this is perpendicular. So I have H, P and B. Correct? So again I'll use the formula. Pandit, Badri, Prashad, Hari, Hari, Bol. Correct? Sine, cos, tan, this is cosec, sec, cot. So I have sine theta is equal to P by H, that is X by P is equal to X, H by root 2X. That comes out to be 1 by 2, root 2. Similarly, cos theta is also equal to B by H, B is X, H is root 2X. That is also 1 by root 2. Tan theta, this is theta actually, is equal to P by B. So it comes out to be P is X, B is X, 1 by 1. So it's 1. Similarly, you can find cosec theta is equal to H by P. H by P, that is root 2X by X, that is root 2. Similarly, we have sec theta is equal to, I have H by B. H by B is equal to root 2x by x, and that is also root 2. Similarly, cot theta is nothing but B by B. B by B is equal to x by x, that is. So I got all the values of theta, and they are all theta is equal to 45 degrees. So I have sine 45 is equal to 1 by root 2, cos 45 1 by root 2, tan 45 1, cosec 45 root 2, sec 45 root 2, and cot 45, all the values of 45 degree. Now let's find trigonometric ratio for 30 degree and 60 degree. So ABC is equilateral triangle, all sides 60 degree, all angles 60 degree, and all sides of length 2a. This is 2a, this is 2a. And if you see this, this is 30 degree, the other 30 degree, this is the angle bisector, so this sides will be equal, right, because the angle is equal. So this is A, and this is also, see, this is 30 degree, this is 60 degree. Actually, both the sides are congruent if you see. Why? Because this is 30 degree, this is 60 degree, right? Two angles are matching, and one side is common, AD. So both the sides, both the triangle are congruent. So both the length will be equal, BD will be equal to DC. So both the length are A and A, the total length is 2A. Now, let's find this length of AD. AD will be equal to root of, in this triangle, if you take triangle ABD is a right triangle. So root of AB square minus BD square. Correct? So this becomes root of 2A square minus A square. That is root of 4A square minus A square. That is root of 3A square. That is root 3. So this is nothing but root 3A. Now if you see, my life is simple. Why? Because I have a triangle at theta 60 degree and above all the sides, root 3a, a and 2a. Similarly, if I take this angle theta 30 degree, I also have all the three sides. So let me take first this angle theta as. So I'm trying to find, I'm taking b as my frame of reference. So this will be h. Let me draw this again here. Correct? So b, a and d. This is 90 degree and this is 60 degree. Correct. So this will be h anyway. Since this is my frame of reference, this will be perpendicular and this will be base. Now this is 2a. Put in circles. This is root 3a and this is a. We have all the sides. Now if I want to find sine b or sine 60 degree, this will be equal to, it is the formula again, Pandit Badri Prashad, Hare Hare Bol, sine cos tan cosec sec cot. Sine theta is nothing but P by H. That is P by H. What is P? Root 3A. Root 3. What is H? 2A. So this becomes root 3 by 2. Similarly, you have to find cos B or cos 60 degree. This will also become B by H. This will be B by H. What is the value of B? A. And H is 2A. So this becomes 1 by 2. Similarly, tan B or tan 60 degree, that is nothing but P by B. What is P? Root 3 A. What is B? A. So this becomes root 3. So I have all this value, sine, cos and tan 60 degree. Similarly, if you want to find cosec 60 degree, it is nothing but 1 by sine. So it will be reciprocal of this. Reciprocal of root 3 by 2 is 2 by root 3. Correct. And sec 60 degree is 1 by cos 60, that is 1 by 1 by 2, that is 2. And cot 60 degree is 1 by tan, that is 1 by 2. So I have all the value of 60 degrees. Correct. I'll circle. Now let me find for 30 degrees. So if I take angle A as my frame of reference, I'll put like this, I'll draw the same way actually, ABD. If angle A is my frame of reference, this is 90 degree, so hypotenuse is constant anyway. If angle A is my frame of reference, this side becomes base and this side becomes perpendicular. Correct. And the length is anyway constant, this is 2A. This is A and this is root 3. Now I have to find, this is 30 degree actually, sine A, that is nothing but sine 30 degree. What is the value of sine 30 degree? Sine 30 is nothing but P by H. P by H. What is the value of P? A, H, 2A. So this becomes 1 by 2. Similarly, cos of A or cos of 30 degree, same thing. This will equal to B by H. B by H. So in this case, B is root 3, A. And H is 2A. So this becomes root 3 by 2. tan of A will be equal to tan 30 degree, and tan is nothing but P by B. Correct? P is what? A. B is what? 2, 3 A. This becomes 1 by. Since we have sine, cos and tan of A, we can find cos A K, that is 1 by sine A. So 1 by 1 by 2, that is 2. That is sine cos 30 degree. Sec 30 degree will be equal to 1 by cos 30 degree. That is 1 by root 3 by 2, that is 2 by root 3. And cot of 30 degree will be equal to 1 by tan 30 degree, that is 1 by 1 by root 3, that is root 3. So I got all the values. These are values of cosec 30, sec 30, cot 30. This is sine 30, cos 30, tan 30. Thus we have all the values of sine 30, sine 60, cos 30, cos 60, tan 30, tan 60. That means we have all the trigonometric ratios of 30 and 60. Thank you. Visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thanks once again.